What type of flash is right for your shop? Here are the pros and cons of Quartz and IR Flash Dryer. IR Flash Pros. It's lower cost, it plugs into 110 or 208 power, and it's pretty solid state, so you don't have to replace them very often. But the cons are, once you turn that switch on, it's always on. That means if you are shooting a video and actually walk out of the set with your flash jar over your platen, things are a little smoky. This can ruin shirts. Also, because they require lower power, they typically take a little bit longer to flash. Now, here's some cons to the Quartz flash dryer. It does require more power, typically 208 to 240 dedicated circuit. They cost more, and the quartz bulbs are delicate, so if you're not careful, you could break one. However, those extra investments are definitely worth the pros to the quartz flash. I think the biggest one is the safety. When you flash with the quartz, it turns on for the amount of time, and then it turns off. If you accidentally leave it on, it's not gonna overflash your shirt, and that takes us to our second point. Because even though this flash requires more power, because it only turns on for a select amount of time, it actually saves energy over the course of the day. Because you're only flashing for 8 to 10 seconds instead of having your flash on all day long, you save between 50 to 80% of your power bill. And when it comes to making money in production, the quartz flash bulbs are faster. This both speeds up production and makes your flashing more consistent. So which one's right for your shop and which one do you use? Drop some questions and comments below. Tag a screen printer if you know they're looking for a new flash. And thanks for watching Empowering the Print with Ryanit. But how the probes. Pros. Pro. Probe. Pro.